What's a mob to a king? What's a king to a god? God to a non-believer who don't believe in anything.
It's your boy Willie B. Yes, 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 we back. Got the vibes coming, you know what I mean? Got to get the vibes right. We back with another one, and it's a special night. We taking it back to 89. We got the queen, okay? Queen Latifah. I remember her initially from Living Single. That was the first time I had seen the queen, and because that was a cool little show. And then, of course, she did the breakout role and set it off, you know, where she was just this iconic lesbian gangster. She killed that shit. That was the role that put her in the super limelight. Like, oh, this chick can really act. And that's before Denzel got shot up in Training Day. Queen is from Newark, New Jersey, which, I mean, I'm not surprised. I can't go nowhere without meeting somebody from Jersey. Y'all get around. People from Jersey, they hustle. They get to it. That is like all they know how to do. They come out the womb just ready to work on something, ready to hustle some shit. They can sell something. This is another one of the icons who, you know, started off as a rapper and then converted to acting. Most people nowadays, they might just know her from all of the movies that she's done, but she was hip hop from the beginning. She was a beatboxer for a females group. It's called Ladies Fresh. She was a member of the Flavor Unit, which I've heard of the Flavor Unit, but I didn't know. See, she's right there in early hip hop. Ended up brushing elbows over at Tommy Boy. So the album, All Hail to the Queen. She got a bunch of producers on this. She got Daddy O, Prince Paul, Louis Vega, DJ Mark, KRS-One producing on this. It's a lot. So I got 15 songs by the Queen. Let's dig in. Heavy jazz influence. You could tell she's got the early jazz vibe going here, uptown shit. But it's still got the right kickback drums on it, like James Brown drums on that. And the Queen is very conversational on this. I like the way she rapping, yo. Yo, she dissecting on this joint. Like, she literally, at the beginning of both verses on this joint, she pretty much did a rhyme scheme that nobody has ever done. She like hid behind the beat, pop back out on you. Like, her rhyme schemes right now is very like, it's very Mayweather. See, I didn't expect that from her rhymes on this first record. Dance to the music. Every time I hear that, I just think of boom, ba boom, ba boom, 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 ba 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 boom, ba boom, ba boom, 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 ba boom, ba boom, ba boom, boom, boom. Okay, so she sampled that same jazz record that LL Cool J sampled on Yeah Jingling Baby, which one of my favorite samples ever. It's just one of my favorite. I think LL's sample was better, like the beat was better. But I like this little take. This beat is kind of it takes you on a journey. It takes you on kind of the old school Christmas vibe, hip hop Christmas vibes, and then De La Soul pops out of nowhere and then just start rapping in it. So it makes sense, because I'm sure she was part of that native tongue collective. I'm not sure if this probably is at the beginning of them forming that, you know, because this is her first project. But I know they knew of each other from the streets and just from being around and other people being on. So, and it's good to hear De La Soul on this joint. Like, Queen just got this presence to her when she come on a record that it's like, you're not even thinking female. You're just thinking, oh, boss, the boss is here. You know what I mean? She's bodying these beats. Like, even De La Soul's presence isn't as strong as hers on this record. Give me body, body. Vogue and Pose and, you know, it's that type of vibe going on here. This is straight aerobics music. I know in some regions they really get off to it. It's because it's housey, and I call it aerobics music, but you know, some other people might call it. I wouldn't expect her to do a techno house music type of song, and I think this is the first one I've heard from all of the albums that I've covered. So she's kind of doing something very different on that. Not really my type of vibe of record, you know what I mean? But I do have a respect for how the girl singing on the hook kind of remind me of, like, you know, because I'm from DC, and when you see go-go bands and, like, the female singers of go-go bands, it's a very unique style of singing that they do, and this kind of reminds me of that. I like this beat. It feels like you know, it's almost a Miami vibe, you know, almost like a very cultural vibe, if I can keep it in the States, but definitely some, you know, like going to the Dominican Republic or something. And it's got the instrumentations of that, you know, because she's really coming in just laying it down on this joint. Yeah, this joint got a groove to it. You let that thing sit on you, just that beat to catch you. She riding that joint right. It's smooth. It's some shit you could throw in the ride, you know what I mean? When you're riding through Little Haiti and shit, you know what I mean? Just, you know, grooving. You got your shirt off, it's hot as shit, sweating. It's that type of vibe. A lot of African sounds in here. That's what it is. It's you know, it makes you feel like, you know, you're not in the United States listening to this. You know, it's got those cultural vibes. Heavy. She showed little flashes of her voice too, because she could sing. She's a singer also. She's so talented. She could do anything. She's, you know, the female Jamie Foxx for sure. She just needed, if she could do stand-up comedy, there would be absolutely nothing she couldn't do. She's very smart too. That comes off in her raps because of just the perspective she come from on her joints. And then the words she used very elegant words in her raps. Yeah, I'm sure she put a lot of niggas to shame. And I'm pretty sure she wrote for a lot of niggas too. Just feel like, welcome to Jam Rock. You know, she's definitely like, she's tapping into her, this is a very native cultural beat selection. I don't like the slow flow that they bring in on this joint. They you know, they gotta stay on them jumping uptown beats more so than the slow swag beats. This joint, they kinda, you know, it's kinda stepping out of a lane that they're great in. I like the little hook better. When they start singing on it, it gets more bearable, because, you know, I think it's a record that's meant, you're meant to sing on it than rap, unless you know exactly how to rap on that. I love this song. Obviously, so far the best song on the album to me. It's like the debut of my baby. I'm sorry, I know you married, but it's all in my head. Moni Love, man, it's something about her voice, and she just rips it. She's a pioneer. You know what I mean? I really feel like she influenced a lot of women that came after her. And Queen knew what she was doing by throwing her on this record. You know, this is a big record on her album. I think they led this with a single in the video. So you got Queen and Moni pushing each other off of just women empowerment and just ripping shit. Every woman should listen to this song. Let's start to show off systems and go look alive. The Queen of Latifah, the King of 45, bringing a mixture, a pure flavor. The way the drums beat on this joint, hell yeah, this joint get the smacking right here. This is some player ass shit right here. God, her verse is so clean on this joint too. And she's speaking so much knowledge and, like, just not just women empowerment, just black empowerment, you know, human empowerment. And she dissecting this beat off some player shit. That's crazy. Got that fast pace, and that's pretty dope. I like the pacing of it, and she's barring up, you know what I mean? Slight, she just tapping. Sucks. She's sneaky for guys to listen to because like she raps so dope, but she'd be saying I'm a queen. So you, as a man, you can't really remember all her lyrics fully into your subconscious because, yeah, she throw that queen shit out. This beat had to been produced by KRS-One because KRS is boom bap king, bro. He really knows the essence of it. So, and I just knew by the consistent snatch of this that I was like, oh, this is a boom bap extraordinaire on this joint. Not my favorite exact like strand of boom bap, but it's alright. The message is very good. The song is not really groovy to me though. She brought that Jamaican flavor on this joint with her words and on the hook. She's dope at just she's worked with some beats on here that weren't really my favorite, but because of what she did to it, she made me like actually kind of like it, you know, or like she made it tolerable. It's something here with this song, you know. It's sitting on me like I feel I know people who made versions of this better, but this was like the starting point. Like I feel like when this song came out, you ain't really heard one like this because the beat kind of sounds Cool Moe D-ish, but then she brings in those Jamaican vibes, which changes it completely. Because Cool Moe D wouldn't have did no shit like that. She seemed like the one of the group that you sicking on, motherfuckers. It was like, go get her, queen. You know what I mean? You ain't even got to tell Queen. Queen probably already sniffing it out as that shit happens. You know what I mean? She'd be on the other side of the bar and be right at the fight before it happened.
Yeah.
Ooh, really great sample. I've heard this sample before by another artist too. She said, I am a bill. I'm just a beer. If you remember Schoolhouse Rock. So this Schoolhouse Rock must have came out even around this time or before this time. I didn't know Schoolhouse Rock was so old, you know, because I'm seeing it, you know, mid to late 90s. Rick Ross sampled this on the Yacht Club. Yeah, when I see it. Yes, indeed. She just wins me over. It's like I'll hear a song and I'll be like, ah, I'm cool. But then you just sit there for a minute and that beat kind of rocking on you. And then you start hearing her and you're like, yo, she is spitting. She is saying some crazy shit. The Dance For Me remix. This is the record earlier that I said I didn't like because of the super housey vibes and aerobicsy vibes on it. So apparently I wasn't the only one, and she had to create a remix because she was like, nah, the rhymes I'm saying on this is dope and y'all should be listening. Don't let the beat fool you, you know what I mean?
But we can do this.
Well, goddamn, you know, the remixes is better than the original. Both remixes at the end of this album is better. You should have transferred those, Queen. Should have transferred them. That would have saved you two songs on there. I don't even know how to break this album now that you're doing this. Queen, you wow. You wow for that one. I see what happened though. And sometimes you get the, you put two of the rhymes on two beats, and you was like, you know what? I'm gonna get all y'all on the album. You don't, she ain't wanna let nobody down. That's probably what that is. But I'm gonna tell you, the second two is better than the first two. Okay, so for the last one though, the Princess of Posse, I like the original Princess of Posse. So, in my opinion, if you would have swamped them, so what am I gonna do, Queen? How do I do this? Huh? How do I do this? You done pulled the whammy on me. Album concept and theme, yeah, it's very straightforward. With it's all about women empowerment, black empowerment, and just positioning it of our culture. She's giving it a bit of a facelift, you know, because she speaks a lot of knowledge on this album, and I think the theme is very powerful, man. If you're especially young black females who listen to hip-hop at this time, and you're looking for a voice of guidance, man, you look no further than right here. And I'm sure she inspired a lot of young ladies to rap, even a lot of men to rap, because of just how hard she kick it on him. She's planting seeds into our youth, because it's a very powerful thing she's saying. And if you can get a hold of it, you can learn a lot. Artwork, very simple, very militant, but effective. Just the blank white background, which I've seen on a few albums that I've covered. You know, I remember the MC Light album. She had the blank background, but it's just keeping it simple. What she's wearing is the message. The Africa symbol is the message, and her, that's the album. That's what it feels like. That's what it is. So it adds completely up. It is a powerful message, and she looks like, you know, you never really seen a black female in that light, that high in America, you know. So to see her on this album cover in stores is very powerful image. Production on this was very, very sneaky. You know, it was a couple records on there where I was like, I don't know. But then it was some records that was just undeniable. Some that really surprised you. Really creative cultural canvases on here. A lot of, I feel like, African sounds. A lot of Dominican, Spanish sounds. It's Jamaican influences on here. Some records were a little rough. But maybe they were meant to be. Maybe that was how they intended it to be. Creativity is super high for me because I feel like they took some chances, especially Queen Latifah, because she uses wise words to unlock things in your brain. That's why you have to listen to her, because she drops knowledge. And it's crazy listening to this. I didn't notice how much she sounds like a KRS-One who just kicks knowledge constantly. But then give you, you know, the braggadocious bars in it too. But she putting on, man, for just queens, for black women. I'll give replay value a 5. There are a couple standout records on here. There's legit like 4 records that three or four that I will come back and listen to. 2 for sure. So that's why I have to give it kind of a lower rating. But it's some beats on here that has been revisited, and some vibes that's inspired of an art. Impact to the game and the culture, you know, is pretty high for me also, because of the imagery she brings, the picture she paint throughout the album. So much empowerment and so much knowledge that you can get from just listening to it. And hip hop history is here too. So you just gotta pay attention and listen to it, and you'll get all of that. Just being a young black woman listening to this record would just blow your mind, because you're like, damn, that's somebody like me who rapping like that. So it would change your whole parameter on what women can do in hip hop. Lyrics, which I'm so hard on, man. She was sneaky. She was inventive. She created. She even played with creating a few little rhyme. Cadences. She really stretched what the norm was and played with it, and that's what KRS-One does also, and that's why I feel like she's under that cloth of rapper. Lyrics were very dope, and I feel like her lyrics alone kind of, you know, definitely carried this project. All right, results are in. This album scored a 56 on the Richter scale, on the Whitley scale. It's a good album. And I think that's fitting for this. I think this is my first good album. Like, I haven't rated an album just good yet, you know, but this is a good album. High points of this album is the brain food, you know, the subconscious brain food you can get from it. And then right under that is just really dope production. Before I get out of here, let me give you two records you have to listen to. You got to listen to A King and Queen. That record right there really surprised me. The drums on there, the way they hit is so correct. Number one is Ladies First. You have to listen to that record. Got my girl Moni Love on it, and she rips it a new asshole, and so does Queen. And check out the video. The video's out. Shout out to Queen Latifah. Shout out to all the producers on here. It's too many of y'all for me to just like name right now, but shout out to all of y'all. Magnificent job of just everybody throwing their influence in to make her first project. Shout out to New York, New Jersey. Shout out to Tommy Boy Records. Until we meet again, don't forget to like and subscribe. It's your boy Willie B. Man.